Hello, welcome to Sports Vision, the magazine, and WTMB. Great show we have for you this week. Joe Palo, Mike Cragen, and again, Mike Cragen with both the dogs.
You know who they like.
Fajita and Bear.
And we're going to have a special 4th of July edition next week. Look for it because we'll kind of
back over the last couple
years. A lot
of interesting stuff from what we've done.
Some of the locals around here acting like fools, and not just us, by the way.
That's right. Our new Register of Deeds, in fact, was acting like a fool.
Yeah,
not like
right.
He does in every
that's
day.
That's right. And right here, speaking of not acting like fools, the River Dogs have come on. They're playing well, and that's going to be our first story. And since we got so much to show you,
River Dogs.
We're going right to it. We're going to tell you how they got there. The River Dogs went to Oak Ridge, and here is what happened. Playing the host team first. There they are. That is Preston Scoggins leading off the bottom of the first with a double into the left center field gap. Preston Scoggins, one of the hot hitters on the River Dogs team. Taylor Johnson wheels. Big Johnson scratches out an infield hit right there. There he is. He's on first base. And Scoggins would end up scoring on this pass ball right here as the River Dogs get a 1-0 lead right there. And Matt Reisenhuber's going to come up with a walk. The threat would end there, but the Dogs would not. As right there is Tommy Mitchell with a single, and he would be on base safely. He would be followed by Wild Will Bryant, and he's going to come up with a little looper, and it's going to drop in for a single as Big Will swings a big bat there also. And upcoming now is Jesse Lascuto. And just like Johnson, not expected with an infield hit, but gets one, scratches it out, loads him up for Eric Rodriguez. Rodriguez singles home two, and the Dogs get up 4-1 against Oak Ridge. Next inning now, Chad Fromm is going to lead it, same inning, Chad Fromm loads him up again. And there's a little controversial call because the umpire was, not on Larry Cooper's good side. Let's take a look at him here as he tries to work him a little bit. He's going to talk to him. He's going to laugh.
Watch Larry hit him with the bat.
Now watch. Now he's going to come back and smile.
You didn't get that on tape, did you?
And he almost gets kicked out right here, but just presses it to the point that, the umpire's going to walk away, turn around. I got to show Larry in action because Coach Cooper spent a lot of time doing a good job. And by the way, funded this whole thing for all these kids in here. We appreciate that. Larry Cooper.
Good guy. Although he did hit the umpire with the bat a little bit later on.
Get a little air time right there. He's going to say, you're out of here if you ain't careful.
See?
All right, we're back. Tied at 4 later on. Dogs need a rally. As soon as we get Larry out of the game, there he is. He's gone. Aaron Short.
Aaron, get out of here, Larry.
4-1. 4-1 there. Here we go. Aaron Short now tied at 4. Aaron Short would start it out with a double. He's going to take second. Questionable decision, but somehow he gets in there. I don't know. The camera's going to blur for you. Will Bryant's going to K, but guess what? Catcher misses it. He's on first. We get an extra out. Jesse Lascuto now is going to walk to load him up. And Rodriguez, two key hits in the game. Here comes the second one. River Dogs are going to come out and win this one on this hit right here. As two-run score, it's going to be 6-5. Dogs win over Oak Ridge. Lots of one-run games. Matter of fact, the only losses they had were one-run games. There's your score, 6-5. We're getting ready now to go to game two against the favored Knoxville Impact. A good team. And we're starting out here with Jesse Lascuto. We're down 4-0, and he's going to open up with a walk. Chad Fromm now is going to single into the hole at shortstop. And what do? You got men on first and second. You got a good bunter up. What are you supposed to do? You're supposed to sacrifice yourself, lay it down. And that's what Travis Cragen does right here, lays it down. But it is a good lay down, and he's going to end up being able to beat it out for an infield hit also. So they're loaded up. And guess who's up the bat? The hottest hitter on the team right now, Preston Scoggins. And he's going to double home two runs right there. Scoggins will double home Lascuto and Fromm. Cragen will make it to third base. It's 4-2 now, and Ryan Douglas came up big in this tourney, which is going to be the first one. He's going to send a rocket to right field, the first of two inside the park home runs. Great big diamonds, not going to hit it out, but you hit it a long way, you're in. And you didn't see it right here, but he fell down between first and second, and he's going to stop at third because he thinks he has no chance. We send him at the end, he gets in. And the Dogs take a 5-4 lead against one of the toughest teams in the area here, the Knoxville Impact. But they end up losing it 6-5.
Not much of an impact did they make?
Impact comes back.
They were impacted.
Impacted. They win it 6-5, so we're on to game three the next day. Next evening. Here we go, bottom of the first. Down 4 they are. Down 4. Chad Fromm gets a walk. Travis Cragen is going to send a shot to pass the third base. And there they are. Fromm had stolen second scores. It's 4-1 now. Scoggins is
not going
to
say it
to make it first
oh,
and
yeah,
second.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Where is he from?
As he singles first and second base right there. Douglas now, a hot series, laces a looper to first base. single, I mean, to left field, and they're loaded up right now. And Taylor Big Johnson puts Cragen and Scoggins on the scoreboard here as he gets a big hit. And there is Scoggins coming across, following Cragen across, and it's 4-3. Mitchell's going to walk to load him back up. There's Tommy, Joe's neighbor, runs down to first base. A pass ball will tie it, and Big Johnson, watch his speed. I'm telling you, he slides in safely. We're tied up. Catcher Aaron Short's going to give the Dogs the lead right here with a single up the middle to score Mitchell. And the Dogs score 5 in the bottom of the first, so it's 5-4. Even that says second. I was stuck on second inning the whole time, folks. Yeah. So when you see that, don't think any of it. Bottom two, Chad Fromm with a single. And he makes it on first base. Cragen now with a base on ball is going to make it first and second. Scoggins will score Cragen only as Fromm was picked or caught stealing there earlier on with this hit right here. So Cragen will come around. It will be 6-4 Dogs now. There he is, and Douglas will rip another single here and make it first and second. Here comes Douglas. He'll put Scoggins on second base, himself on first base, and we go now to bottom of the three, and it ends up after that inning being 6-5. Dogs have taken the lead, and we are actually the second inning now. Big Johnson is going to open the next inning with a single. Also swinging a hot bat, Tommy Mitchell with a single now. Going to make it first and second base. There's Tommy. Playing good baseball. Reisenhuber now is going to lay down a great bunt right here to move him. And everyone's going to be safe because they're going to look at third. It's not there. They're going to look back at first. It's too late.
Oh, Matt there.
And Aaron Short delivers a bases loaded single. Two runs will score. There's Short. Here come the two runs across the plate. It's going to be 8-5. Dogs now on a roll. Pass ball will score Reisenhuber. You remember the nice bunt? Watch this. He almost gets head-to-head right here. Boop. Okay, nah, never mind. I'm in there. All right, and that is that makes Tommy Mitchell's niece happy coming up because they're heading 9-5. Take a look at her right here. Good-looking little gal. Grandma Kay is so proud of her. There she is.
Oh, look at that.
She's not a sweetie, and she's happy because the Dogs are happy, and the Dogs are on the final day. One more win, and they make the finals, a rematch against the Impact, and they want them back. First, they got to play the Farragut Dodgers. We see that cute little babe right there. Down 4-0, top of the third. Catcher Aaron Short starts it with a single. He makes it on base. Wild Will Bryant.
Are you breathing?
He's going to follow. Here comes Wild Will. Wild Will? Hey, I'm not breathing now.
Hitchcock.
Gets a single, and he's on first. And there we go with Hunt's first and second base short. And Lascuto now is going to walk to load him up. There's Lascuto throwing that bat. That almost hit me, by the way. Beat him up a little bit after the game. Fromm responds with a two-run single. Short, and Bryant scores 4-2. Cragen follows here with a deep shot to left field, over the left fielder's head. And again, that rolls a long way once it gets there. And Fromm would score. It's 4-3. Dogs are down one. Cragen's going to motor to third base. With
there he looks like he's landing a plane.
Stand up triple. There he is. And Scoggins now is going to bunt and get on for a single. There he is. He's going to make it. Popped it up a little bit, but it fell in play.
Nice.
And Big Johnson coming up with the big stick. He's going to tally Cragen and Scoggins here with a triple. And believe me, a triple for
Taylor
Johnson.
Watch Larry. I can't see him.
Now, a triple by Taylor Johnson is something else because the man, is one thing he doesn't have is wheels, but he had a few things that made him look like he had them here. There he is. Taylor.
He's saying that.
Motoring in the third with a stand-up triple. And he's
Taylor's the fastest kid on that team.
Chris Kugler executes a great squeeze. Team throw the bat at the ball. Squeeze play, you've got to get the bat on it. He does. And then Fromm is going to scratch out an infield hit. Is the next inning now, as that one inning ended, 6-4 Dogs. Cragen's going to rip another shot to the outfield, and it's going to be scoring Fromm, and he would get a double on the throw. Or
scoring Fromm first base,
comes
third
Fromm,
base.
And Cragen's going to get to second base on the throw. Scoggins reaches on an air, and that will score Cragen as the ball sails over the first baseman's head. Cragen trots in, and Big Johnson again coming through once again with a single. It's Cragen scoring. There's Johnson with the single. Scoggins to third base on that single by Johnson. As they make a play over there on him, it's too late. He's standing on third. And he will score on the pass ball right here. And Chris Kugler will single home Johnson. There's Chris, and it's 10-4 now. As we move on to the next inning, the Dogs are enjoying themselves and having a roll. Next inning now, they get more as Aaron Short will walk. There he is. Will Bryant will reach on an air. As you see right there, the ball not handled at second base. Aaron Short's on second.
Oh, he got knocked down twice.
Short will make it to third there as Bryant stands up on second base. And a pass ball will score Reisenhuber, who's running for Short. Here comes Reisenhuber across the plate. There is the score. And right here, Cragen with a little shot. Look at how quick that ball is back. That ends the inning right there. He wasn't happy, but it hitting the ball hard. The Dogs go on to win that 6-5 and get another shot at the impact.
Do you have more?
One more. Ooh. Right here. Look at that guy in the middle. Good-looking guy, big guy. All right, here we go.
Wake me when it's over.
Dogs taking him on. Here it is. Scoggins is going to reach right here on an error to begin with. And Ryan Douglas, watch this. He had two of these.
Who's that coaching first base?
Here it is, Ryan Douglas. Look at that shot. Great shot. Look at that. Over the left fielder's head. I mean, tell you, that was too far to hit over, but to hit to the wall, that was a great shot. He will get another inside the park home run.
Look at Larry. It looks like he's waving a plane in.
There he is. And the Dogs are killing.
Ken Douglas on first
base? They are right now killing. Yes. No. First base, that's Mr. Fromm. Killing.
Oh, Jack.
As an inside the park by Douglas. They are killing,
Jack,
I say, once
Ken
again.
Like
the impact. And Lescudo there with a base hit to left field. Fromm now is going to get up and walk as the impact is going to take a 4-0 lead and go into the fourth with it here on this great team right here. Everybody thinking of upset of the day. And Cragen again with a
nice
perfect bunt right there. And the base is going to be loaded. He went for a sacrifice, got a hit out of it, so we're loaded up.
Camera lady went a little crazy there.
Douglas with two more RBIs right here as he, again, he had a big series. He gets a single right there. And Dogs are, he's out of second right here, as you see. If you try to stretch it, but, you know, been hitting good, we can forgive that. There he is, out second base. Two runs scored. Dogs up 4-0, but they would lose it 5-4. I'm not going to show you that impact to come back because we don't care about what they did right there. But how about
that? I'm thinking that's because Jack Fromm was on first base. If Ken Douglas would have been on there, that may not have happened.
That's right. And there it is, the scoreboard. As we just showed you, River Dogs second.
I'm only kidding, Jack.
Second place finish in a row, that's hard to say, in Elk Ridge, 14 and under. Classic. How about them
Dogs? It's pretty good, isn't it?
Who let the Dogs out, huh?
How about them Dogs?
How about them Dogs? All right, how about a commercial?
We got to go. We 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's do it.
Check into cash. That's Check into Cash. It's a remarkable place to get instant emergency cash for a flat fee. Anytime you have an unexpected expense and need a payday advance, Check into Cash can make it happen. You write us a personal check and you get the cash you need instantly. My checking account's low. I can't get what we need. Go to Check into Cash. The next time you need quick cash, for whatever reason, go to Check into Cash.
Remember how you loved going to the local diner with your parents for an authentic French dip sandwich? No, you avoided going out with your parents. You were embarrassed by their matching sweatsuits. You must be thinking of Hardee's new authentic French dip sandwich. Roast beef carved to order, covered with Swiss cheese and piled high on a freshly baked roll. Perfect for dipping in our famous au jus sauce. Might want to take Mom and Dad through the drive-thru. Try Hardee's new French dip sandwich. Hardee's, the way food ought to be.
Buildings and employees do more than take up space. We're more than just checkbooks and loan applications. We are part of this community, just as the community is part of us. Our people have been here for years. We've worked alongside you at the Heart Walk in United Way. We reinvest both time and money, which adds to the quality of life in Bradley County. Any bank can lend money. It takes a neighbor to lend a hand. First Tennessee. All things financial. All things Cleveland. All things community. Member FDIC.
Cleveland Chiropractic Clinic offers complete chiropractic care. Dr. Russell Smith and his friendly, dedicated staff can help relieve chronic back pain, neck pain, headaches, allergies, and also sport-related injuries. Cleveland Chiropractic Clinic has a licensed massage therapist on staff and 2 certified in-house x-ray technicians. Complete insurance filing is available and 24-hour emergency care. Phone 472-1140.
Hey! We're back in Sports Vision.
We're back, and I tell you what, Industrial Park tournament action is back, Joe. And the 5, 6, 7, 8s, cute little kids out there going at it. And
good ball players.
And you know what? They are good ball players, and it's important to them and their parents. And I tell you, right here before, I forgot to show you the Sports Vision trophy. There it is, by the way. Sports Vision trophy. What am I talking about? River Dog trophy.
No, that's the Sports Vision
trophy. Putting this on his.
He gave it to us now. You think he's getting it back?
Sports Vision next week. Let's go to some industrial action.
Try and find us.
There's a couple of people got trophies there. Start with a 5-6, Joe. Take it away.
We're scaring the dog. 5-6 Industrial Park Tournament. Here we go. We've got the Pirates up. Philip Holcomb leads off with a single. And there he is. He's on first base. Wheels Holcomb, as they call it. Ryan Johnson, also with a single, which takes Holcomb to second base. Look at the pitcher hustle for the ball there. All right, here we go. Jedediah, that's what I said. Kidwell loads him up with a single. Sorry about that, Jedediah. I know your dad once. Ryan Haggard gets to third base, brings home Holcomb, Johnson, Kidwell. Three runs are in now for the Pirates. Look at that slide right there.
Yeah, it looks professional.
Look, there's another one.
Look at that.
Let's see, third one come in and do that.
You just have fun, don't
you? Okay. No, he's on third base. All right, here we go. Jacob Hicks gets a Hicks to first base. There he is, a single there for Jacob. Tristan Sherman now will follow with another single. And we got the things moving for the Pirates. All righty. Logan Russell. Oh, let's see. Tristan will go on to second base. He gets a double because of the little error there, single's error. All right, here we go. Logan Russell. He gets a single, and then a run comes home. Everybody's sliding today. All right. So we've got a run there. It's now 6-0 lead for the Pirates. The Royals now. Javon Bell leads off with a double. Is that Dee Dee out there?
No. Dee Dee's graduated to 11-12.
Oh, they let him do the big guys.
He's up with the big boys now.
All right. He wasn't doing any good with the 5-6. Here we go. Trey Moore now follows with a single. And hold the ball up. That's right. Everybody's got to stop. Tevin Shaw slaps a double to score a run. And this is, of course, the Royals.
That's Moore.
More scores than 7 years ago. I have to say it. Elijah Hamey with a single. And, all right, the short single, but he gets there. Alex Strickland now would get up. No, this is Heather Bellamy, I believe. That was Strickland. Heather. Is that Heather?
That was Alexis Strickland.
Alexis. Did I say Alex? Oh, I'm sorry.
That's Alexis.
All right, now it's Heather.
Now it's Heather.
I get them confused because they're both very good ball players.
There goes Alexis right there.
Alexis is going on her way to second base. There we go. This is Heather Bellamy. And she's not one of the Bellamy brothers. She's a Bellamy sister. She gets a single.
You want me to do it?
Go ahead.
My Bellamy.
Da-da-da-da. John Gaither with a single that will score a run. And there's the throw. Here comes the run. And
isn't that appropriate? Right, sweet child of mine plays to this, too. I mean, this is sweet. These little 5- and 6-year-olds love it.
All right. Back to the Pirates later on in the game. Jenny
Rigel. That's Becky's granddaughter.
Rigel. I know.
How about that? Number two. Watch this. She's going to get put out at first, but she has to. Look at Mama coaching.
She takes a runner on to third base.
Look at Mama coaching right there.
If Stacy just leave her alone, the kid can run. Telling her to clean her room when she gets home. All right, here we go.
Back to the Royals.
Back to the Royals again as we've got another hit. And we've got a concerned catcher. And look at that guy pointing his bat.
Devin Shaw
on the hit. Here we go.
Now he's got to go back and forth here. He's not really into the game. Here we go.
Bit.
Another hit.
This is Haney brings a run home and gets a double. Here we go. Is that what we got going here once again? All right, this is Alexis Strickland again. Is that Alexis?
Mm-hmm.
All right, she gets her second hit, and the catcher is still concerned, you'll see, but a run comes home.
Watch after the run comes. Now watch the catcher here. She into the ball game here. Watch this.
Watch this.
Watch this. She's like,
hey, there's the...
Now watch Dad over there behind the fence. There's a guy behind the fence telling him to pay attention. See the
He's going to the movies right after the game.
Here we go.
All right, here we go. The Royals are up 15-8. Now watch...
That was Heather.
Watch the outfielder here. Let's see, first go back here. Watch the outfielder. You're going to see this? Got to clean the area up.
Look at her. She's having some. All right. See you in the ballgame. I just had to show that. It was so cute. Look at her.
Reminds me a lot of when you played.
15-8.
All right. Now we're going to watch the outfielder. Now see out there?
Look at that guy.
He's in there. Is he concerned?
Well, tell who got the hit.
The hit was Holcomb.
Yeah, Holcomb. And look at what he does.
He's rolling over. All right. He's like, you know.
Okay, I'll get up.
Come on.
Coach is hollering at me.
The grass was just mowed. It smells so nice.
You got that hit.
This is Kidwell.
I'm
moving. I got it. Got our outfielder now.
Now look at it. He's still concerned.
5, 6, 7, and I'm playing Nintendo when I get home. And I hope we're eating hamburgers. All right, and then here we go. Got Dylan Moore adds another hit. Not enough, though. The Royals go on to win, and there's a run.
They get a run, but it's not enough. It's the Royal Blue. The Royals do win it, and they are.
We're going to win some more here.
The Pirates get a couple of runs here. We're showing them to get a couple of runs.
Run!
All right, there we go.
Stacy should have been telling him to run there. What is she doing?
There they are. Hey, how about that? Is that not fun?
That is
fun.
Very fun. And
they're
good ball players.
They're enjoying it. Look, there's the catcher right there without her helmet on.
See?
All right, doing a great job.
All right, that was very
good. All right, we're moving on to the 7-8 finals. Cubs and Mets, and up 7-2. The Cubs are leading the bottom of the second. Cubs' Logan Harbison leads off with a double right there. Makes it down in there. Colton Reynolds is going to take one deep.
Everybody on the team's over there by second.
Colton Reynolds deep, left field. Harbison's going to score. Here he comes around.
Everybody on the team is in left
field. They're all out there. It's 8-2. Cubs big. This Cubs team went undefeated for the year, ladies and gentlemen. 22-0 regular season. Trevor Guthrie's one reason why. He finds a hole in shortstop in the infield, and Harbison's going to race home right here. Watch him. He's going to keep on going. They keep on undefeated here. It's going to be mostly all Cubs. You're going to see Shane Hill going to join the hit parade right there with a single to get an RBI. And look at this, it's 10-2 Cubs. Now you talk about some confusion going to go on here, Joe. Next inning, Dakota Rumbelo is going to get a single, okay?
Yeah.
Now Patrick Carroll's going to pop a looper, whatever you want to say,
Papa
to first.
Loop-a-bop-a.
Now watch, it doesn't get caught, but there's a man on first. Do we got an infield fly rule, or do we? Or do we got a guy passing a guy up for an out, or do we? What do we got? Well, the batter ends up on third base right there, okay, and the run's going to score. But watch the discussion afterwards. He's safe at third. Watch this. Now, wait a minute. Was that an infield fly? Did he pass my runner-up? Just a second now. This isn't right. This shouldn't count. This is 7-8, and it's already 10-2 Cubs, okay? Now, we're going to go over here and check this out. And we're going to have some discussion. We're going to go to the fence, and we're going to ask another umpire to come over. Somebody. What are we going to do? Well, this guy was here. Now, look at this. We know that looks like a Cannon getting all upset right there. Paul Cannon saying,
that
hey,
is Paul Cannon.
What's going on right here? I mean, hey. Okay, now they stop it. This was 20 minutes of my tape. I'm not kidding. They stopped it to come back. They go back out the field. He waves them back over again. We're going to talk about it again. Here we are. And then we're going to talk about it some more.
And what?
And, you know, whether or not the guy was out at first in this 7-8 game, the championship, I realize 20 years from now, everybody's going to remember what happened. All right, finally, though, Josh Yates gets to drive home a run. But they left the guy on third, as you notice. He came in right there.
Right.
And Dugan Cannon must be related to Big Paul. Dugan Cannon with a single. Pretty good shot right there. Out hits his own man, no sweat. All right. And Dakota Williams now with an RBI is going to give the Cubs a 16-4 lead. This undefeated team is pretty tough. I got to show the Mets. We got there after the first one. They scored two runs. They got a few more here later after we watched the Cubs come in there with another run. Mets add a little at the end. Kevin Carr, that was him, just single. Calvin now with a – that's Kevin Carr right there with a single.
Right.
Okay, this is back to the Mets.
You're not confused.
And this is Jamal Calvin now. He's going to make it first and third. Come on, Jamal. We got to have the Mets get some. There's a man first, man on third right now. And here we go with another Cannon. Paul Cannon this time. We got Dugan Cannon on one team, Paul Cannon on the other. Paul Cannon's going to drive home a run right here. And not enough, though, as the Cubs are going to win really big.
There you go.
And they are the champions. Seen them lining up right there. So we have got Industrial Park champions. We showed you last week the 9, 10, 11, 12. We show you this week the 5, 6, 7, 8. And there they are. Take it away.
There you go, Industrial Park Tournament. As we showed you, 7-8 championship. The Cubs are in first place. The Mets take second. And we move on to the 5-6. And you see that the Royals are the champions there, and the Pirates come in second. So,
all right, man. We got to come in first with the hearts of all our people who support this show. We got to go to another commercial break.
Got a lot of good supporters.
We'll be right back.
Man, I am running short on cash with the car repairs, and our wedding anniversary is coming up next week. I need some cash, fast. But from where? I know. Matt was telling me about how First Southern Cash Advance helped him.
May I help you?
He just wrote them a check, and he got the cash right away. That's easy. I can do that. Then First Southern holds your check until your next payday. It's quick, confidential, and helps take care of life's really important things. First Southern Cash Advance. Cash when you need it most.
The employees of Duracell's three area facilities would like to give hearty congratulations to our three area high schools for excellence in academics and athletics. Rucker Valley High School, Cleveland High School, and Bradley Central High School. Keep up the good work, students. We are proud of you. From your local Duracell facilities, Mouse Creek Tasso, and the Corporate Distribution Center and Warehouse. At Duracell, our people are our energy.
Gotta do the Duracell wave every time. I gotta do the Duracell
wave.
It's the
queen wave.
Hey, we haven't covered this team a lot, but they're coming on. This team was getting, getting beat all over the pool for a while, this Aqua Tiger team, and early on, they're coming back. They're making it close. They've won a couple meets. They had a squeaker leading the whole way against the Colonial Shores. Let's take a look at that right there.
Let's check it out here. Here we go.
People in the water. Here they are.
13, 14-year-olds. This is the girls' breaststroke, and we have in here Rebecca Swan, Kate Bender, Becca Davis, and TJ Smith. Again, 13, 14-year-old girls' breaststroke. Move on to 13, 14-year-old boys' breaststroke. Will Daigle and Matt Sims. And there you go there. All right.
Switch away here a minute. We're going to watch them, though.
Watch them for a second as they go bob up and down. That's the breaststroke, Mike. That's why this is called the breaststroke. You know? All right. We move on now. Girls, 15, 18-year-old, 50-yard breaststroke. A lot of breaststroking going on here, but we got it all happening. Mary Gregory, Allison Eskew, Shannon Asquith, and Sarah Beth Casey as they stroke their way down to the other end of the pool.
Oh, she nipped her right at the end.
Oh, my goodness. Boys, 15, 18-year-old, guess what? Breaststroke. And a little less, but still it's the same. There they go, Daniel Connor, Stuart Carter, Rob Streeter. Now, This is the boys' breaststroke. That's what we're showing there. That's the guys I just mentioned. I'll name them again. Daryl Connor, Stuart Carter, and Rob Streeter. And I think it's unfair for boys to participate in the breaststroke. We've got the girls 8 and under 100-yard medley. And no, this is not a song. It's a backstroke, is what I think that's called there. Madeline Scoggins, Jen O'Neill, Allison Faggart, and Bristol Snyder.
I believe that's little Scoggins right there. That's Fast Eddie at the Tavern's daughter right there.
There you go. And they call him Fast Eddie for a reason.
Swim meet, final score, Colonial Shores squeaks by the Tigers, 382.5 to 365.5. Ellen Schaefer, Christy Snyder, the big guns, 19 points apiece for those Aqua Tigers. All right, and moving right along, we're going to head right on to some athletes of the week, and they were so cute to watch them. 7-8s aren't so cute. They're just a little bit,
cute.
A bit older. I mean, not cute. I mean, they just, they play a little more ball up there, and they throw
some. 7-8s are ugly kids.
Oh, no, no, no. 5 and 6, 7 and 8, industrial champions. Let's take a look at
9 and 10-year-old kids are ugly, but 7 and 8 aren't.
Let's take a look. Throw it up there. Right there they are. The Cubs, 7 and 8 champs, receiving their trophies. Didn't get a good full shot of them as a team, but getting them kind of try to get everybody in there with Candace Cameron.
Congratulations, guys.
They won't even let us on the field anymore. How about that? Let's complain to Beth.
There's a big Ryan in the paper.
All right, now, here comes is the Royals in the 5 and 6 getting theirs. They're both wearing blue, so the littler kids, though, they got to be the 5-6. There they are.
There they go.
5-6 Royals getting theirs.
Congratulations.
And how about that?
Thank you, checking the cash.
Athlete of the week and checking the cash. And, hey, be sure to stay tuned for our 4th of July special next week.
Next
we got
week.
A lot of fun that we did the last couple of years. We've edited some stuff together for you. Have a serious piece at the end because all that stuff we did was pre-9/11. Of course, we know how much America means to us after 9/11. And we hope these people all enjoy that show and have a great 4th of July coming up.
Exactly.
And
I'm ready for it, aren't you?
What are you going to do?
I'm going to fire a firecracker.
You're going to fire a firecracker. I'm going to fire
I'm going to fire a couple of firecrackers.
I'll fire a firecracker.
I may do an M80.
I'm going to pull an M80 up my nose and
I may do an M80 in 2 or 3 or 4 or 10.
2 or 3 or 4. Hey, we got to go.
Go like that, 2, 3, 4, 10.
Redneck.
We end up, say, back over here. Which one's highest in the ceiling now? His left one. What would that toe do? Come over here. I dig my heel. I don't have to grapevine with my toe. I use my toes here. When I come over, it's my heel here. See his leg right there? It's my heel here. And I'm pulling back. You can't feel that, but I'm pulling back on coach's leg tight. And from here, if that's what I had coach in a match right here, I would swap off. I got the half on the wrong side, don't I? Turn him here. Let's take him back over there, which I can do maybe. I just swap. There's his wrist right there. Take it. Change the half. Go here. There's my half. My leg's already over. Could I come over the top? Of course I can. Look to throw a leg over and have no space. This thing where guys are getting us here, we have crab ride, we have elevators, underhooks there with our feet, and he's trying to no control pin us and stuff, and we're elevating. You know, hey, I'm glad you're trying to get out of there. Don't stay here. No control pin. That's a bad way to get out of a state tournament. I got to know I can slide out either way, but as I slide out, look to bring a leg over. Elevating here, slide my hips this way, leg comes over here. Now who's in control? He thinks he was a good of no control pin me? No, I'm going to pin your butt now. Pulling tight, squeezing. No control pin me, coach. I got a leg over, I got a lot more control over it. No control pin right here? No way. I got a half, I got an inside wrist, a leg over, a leg under. Don't keep riding here all the time. Sometimes, yes, you got a great half and a great crank. You get here, and his hip comes straight over. There. Now you try to follow him, and even if you do, are able to follow him, he's off his back. Oh, you come off that one day, Jesse, and you said, I'm going to quit throwing legs. Remember at the region or something? I just suck at legs. No, you don't suck at legs. You are good at legs. You can be great at legs because you have a great crank, you have great feel, you have great hips. You just got to fix a couple of problems. And a lot of us got to fix a lot of problems with legs. We can be great and awesome with them. Some of us are good with them. Look to throw a leg over. One under, one over. Slide out, slide right, slide left. Look for the wrist, look for the half. But you control the situation. When I got a guy in a crab ride, all of a sudden, I'm the defensive wrestler? That's crap. How does that happen? Take control. Go to a claw, false half, wrist and a half, wheelie, take him backwards, explodes. Dustin? Justin, remember your name, this kid? Take it. Take it. God, I received that day in practice, and I'm like, God, he's got such a good feel. Just knows where to put his feet and his knees, and well, it's awesome. Your natural feel you have from here, and you work at it, too. But you're here, and it's Kale Sanderson time. Yeah, you go this way, you look at the club, you might score no, you go this way for a while, and you're pretty dang good at it. But if you would just go here and get a little bit of out force in right here, I wasn't as slick on that stuff as you with those elevators stuff. Well, he had great elevators too, but he wasn't real slow rolling. He'd take it straight back over, it was like, wham, go. Take it back here, all the way back, and then run that half like crazy. And the guy is stuck because they never see it coming. And never ever see it. Alright? Go back. Get me out of that stuff.
No, you're just taking, you take yours a little more to the side and you throw the leg in before you elevate. You see what I mean? Like if I'm taking him to my left right here, a lot of times, if I'm wanting to take him this way because this is the way I'm going to have, I've got to elevate this leg right here to start with. I've got to get him back this way. I like taking him straight over much better because he's going to be standing up on the pin. But you get here sometimes even, and you're trying to like take him over and hope that you can just crawl over the top right there. The good guy's not going to let you do that. You've got to catch him off guard a little here and elevate his legs high right there. Now I'll crawl over the top. You see what I mean? You leave that leg, you've got a leg in too soon almost. You've got to get his feet in the air and get him elevated up before you try to crawl over and run his hat. That's what puts him on his head as you elevate him. Now you do it really well. But you just gotta
go to next gear with it.
Yeah.
Instead of doing it in third gear, do it in fifth gear. And pinch.
I want him off my head. I want him off my head. Now I can do this right here. Attach his head to his knee and take him right there. But if that guy's trying to get his foot back in there, it's gonna be tough. I like it out here because he can't get his foot back in.
I like
finish hard. That's all it is.
If I'm wrestling coach, he takes me either way there, I'm in trouble. When I hit that, I like to go to the butt. I do. I can hear a finger to the butt like you're talking about. But when I do it, I do it hard. I mean, it's wham, kicks, thunder mat. When he goes forward, it's the same thing. It's done with a lot of intensity. Drives me, knocks me out of bounds. I don't have a chance to switch and get my hips hurt.
Because if you don't hit it hard and you go stepping and crap, and I just step in it, he'll knock you to your side over and over with us. We go to step in and do something, we just halfway do it, and we end up on our side, and we hit a single leg. You can't, that's unacceptable. If you got a single, you got to finish every time, and that's just keeping good position. If you can't now, then it's your fault. All right? Get after it this weekend, and you will finish, because that's what it all boils down to.
I just remember that because it was on my notes. Why are you taking it to the hand?
Yeah. I mean, if you take it to his butt, I don't care. If you can take it to his butt, you always want to take it to his butt. But, I mean, there's going to be times when if that guy's hanging on my head or doing something crazy, hey, get your two, you know?
Coach, show him real quick. Just give him the knee slide hip throw thing. I know.
I don't know how to convince you this. This weekend, I swear, I wish somebody would just pick up on it. I didn't get this forever, even in college, like how important this was until I started watching college tape. And how does every guy get out of bottom? They keep their hips through constantly. All the time they're trying to get their hips through. They'll hit a Granby, they'll go to Peterson, they'll do whatever. I mean, their hips are through though. I used to think a sit out, that sucks. I mean, a sit out, that's like the first move you learn in wrestling. If you really hit a sit out though, you're in pretty good position. As long as you don't get sucked back, there's nothing else he can do to you. There's space in there, there's a lot of stuff you can do. Again, from any position, whether he's got a spiral, all right. A cross wrist, whatever, my inside knee has got to come through. I get on my toes here, and I just slide my hips through right here. Now I'm in good position. I can fight him all day long. I'm not just going to stand up here. What am I going to do first? Attack his hand. Here, his hands aren't locked. I'm out every time. If I'll do that. If I don't, I won't be out every time. I'll be right back on the mat fighting for my belly. Other side. Either way, this is my inside knee now. This is my inside knee. That thing's got to come through. I'm here. I slide my hips through, now I'm out. I got his hand control. Here, I'm away. Every time. If he's got a cross wrist right here. He's got here. If I can get this knee through, am I in better position now? What's his turn from here? He might try to, like, take me that way, chop over. I'm just going to circle, and I'm right out the back door because when I sit my hips through, what does that create? Here, my hips, there's a big space right there. If I stay here and he chops my arm, there's no space. None. If he's got a bar, right here. I can't do anything. Look, I'll sit right here. My hips are through. There's space. I'm going to turn away, do whatever.
If I've got a problem, that's what you're thinking. But I'm a Bradley guy. I'm like, good, you're not going to have space, coach. It doesn't matter because he's in such good position that I'm going to close the gap on him. I'm wrestling live. You have to stand to wrestle, but I'm wrestling live. And I get in that situation, and he's got such great position on bottom that even when I got across, when I got across wrist, say, he doesn't go sit down, there's space. And I think, what? No space, right? And I'll close the gap. I can't take him right or left. He's got a great base. He's got little feet on his butt, just barely move around. So I close the gap, and I crowd it. He's got such good position and good hand fight, even when I go here, He's beat me in my hand fight because his position is so good right there. So, yeah, a good guy can close the gap on you and take the space away. But I can't free my right hand. I can't get my hand out of there to do whatever I might do because he's got perfect hand control, elbows in.
And if this guy's thinking about closing the gap, is he thinking about a turn? No, he's got to close that gap before he can turn it. Hey, I'll constantly make him close that gap. Hopefully, I'm in better shape. I'm going to wear him down. I'm going to eventually get my escape. All right? If you don't create a gap there, even I've gotten ridden out. That guy on that video, Casey Cunningham, rode the living crap out of me. I had no idea how to get out of bottom against him. He unbelievable. He kept my ankles tied up. I couldn't get my hips through. I couldn't get space in there. I mean, I still don't have a clue. I'd love to talk to the guy and say, how do you get away from him? How in the world could I get away from him? You know,
I didn't get a sword arm.
No. I mean, you just couldn't get away from him. From here, though, if I stay here, coach is going to go automatically to work in the turn or something. If I don't stay here and I get here, he's not going to go to work in the turn. I don't just lean back right here. My heels are moving constantly. I'm looking for this. Once I got this, guys, I'm fine. If he's over this arm right here, what am I going to do? Hey, I'm just going to swim. Hey, I'll just swim out right there.
Hey, get the ring.
Hey, that might look good.
Move. You'll get it. Jump your hand.
Stick around and support the team. You still stick around. You don't leave. You don't
pull some things, guys in the past pulled a couple times, disappear on us. You know, Saturday night, the finals, one of our best guys on the team got put out already. He was out on a date Saturday night here in Cleveland. Didn't come back to support his teammates or anything. I'm sorry. He's a good kid. I like him a lot. But it was sorry. I told him I'm sorry. You know, we're a team. We're a team win or lose. If you get put out, that's a real tragedy. You try to avoid that. That's up to you. But you come back and support your teammates. Student center and the game room and stuff, I don't mind you guys going over there when it's the appropriate time. When it's between sessions, it's the program, it's a guy, you need something to eat. The student center's over there. Go eat. Here's your meal money. When you go and eat, you go down there and play game pool or something or ping pong, it's 2 hours for Wrestling Stars. I don't mind that. But you have enough maturity and a watch. I watch, and you get back in plenty of time. That one year had to go get somebody out of the game room. Who was it, Alan? Miles Mosley?
Miles Mosley.
To go, he's playing the team. He's on deck. On deck in the consolations. And somebody, go find him. Go. They're running around. They found him. He's playing ping pong. He's getting finished. He did
win. I didn't know.
Well, did he make it?
He made it.
Did he win?
No, he got
it. He made it early to die that day.
We're not going to meet as a team anymore. It's our last practice. As a whole team like this. Might meet you somewhere in the classroom or something. It's the last practice. Let me tell you this. Freestyle will help you. This year, we didn't win the state in the gym. And I don't want to pin on anybody. And I'm not going to. It's not any one person. It happened at various places. Let me tell you this. We're going to fall short again next year. All we got to do is have Stud. Place winner, champ, defending place winner, runner up. Weak link. Okay, guy. See what I'm saying? The weak links beat your butt. The weak links are where they can shift people and move people, and that's where you lose dual meets. Let's not color it. That's where you lose dual meets. Not a lot of commitment, it's some, a little bit. You gotta do it. You guys have a good chance to start next year, you know who you are. You guys, don't give you a chance to start, work hard. We have a good chance and a good team. Cleveland thinks next year is their year. That's it, we're talking for years. Juniors that are gonna be seniors next year, that's the class that went on forever. That's the class that's gonna knock Bradley off. That's the ones. They've waited, they've been in 10 years. And they have a good team going back. We're losing 4 seniors, not losing anybody. And it's gonna come down to me next year, I want to grab one of you guys and go, we're going to crack for you for the last 8 months. I ain't seen you. And here you are. You're the guy getting pinned. You're the guy losing. You're the guy with no self-confidence. You're the guy that can't hit a shot because you have no confidence in your shot. We can be good, guys. Great. You guys have to do something in the offseason. And it's not much commitment. It is not. It's fun. It's just messing around. Missing practice yesterday. Nothing. Today we didn't go hard. It's nothing. You know, the guys race the Ironman and stuff in Hawaii. They train. They take 6, 7, 8 days off before they race. You don't lose shape that fast. You don't gain it in 3 or 4 days. You don't lose it in 3 or 4 days. So anybody thinks, we didn't go
far, but that's a couple days. Now I lost my shape. I'm not confident in the third period. We're in great shape. We're in the best shape of anybody in the state. If I thought you were going to lose shape in 2 or 3 days,
we'd have been going hard as we could the last 2 days. But the point is, the fact is, you don't lose anything. We're ready. We're in shape. We're healthy. We should be rested. Our injuries should feel a little bit better. Muscles should feel good. And we're in great cardiovascular shape. And we're going to act like we're on the mat. Keys to winning, I'm going to do these quick. I know I get long-winded, I'm going to do these quick. And Coach Papa, talk to you for a second. I'm sure he wants to do it.